This is Bishop George Murray. On behalf of your Catholic friends and neighbors in the Diocese of Youngstown, I invite you to join us for this celebration of the Holy Mass.
Good morning, and welcome to our celebration of Holy Mass. Today is the sixth Sunday of Easter. Our celebrant is Father John Michael Lavelle, pastor of Our Lady of Mount Carmel Church in Niles. I am Tom McCarthy from St. Charles Borromeo in Boardman. As we pray this Mass, let us remember in our prayers Bishop George Murray.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God our Father, and the unity of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, this past week, our Bishop George Murray was diagnosed with a form of acute leukemia. Over the next 4 weeks, Bishop Murray will undergo intensive chemotherapy. We ask that everyone throughout the Diocese of Youngstown keep Bishop Murray in their prayers in these coming days. And as we celebrate this Mass, let us also call to mind those many opportunities we have each day to share the love of the Lord with one another. For those times that we have failed in this endeavor, let us now seek his outpouring of mercy, forgiveness, and peace. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance may always be held to in truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Peter entered, Cornelius met him, and falling at his feet, paid him homage. Peter, however, raised him up, saying, "Get up. I myself am also a human being." Then Peter proceeded to speak and said, "In truth, I see that God shows no partiality. Rather, in every nation, whoever fears him and acts uprightly is acceptable to him." While Peter was still speaking these things, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who were listening to the word. The circumcised believers who had accompanied Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit should have been poured out onto the Gentiles also, for they could hear them speaking in tongues and glorifying God. Then Peter responded, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit even as we have?" He ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for him, his holy arm.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
The Lord has made his salvation known. In the sights of the nations, he has revealed his justice. He has remembered his kindness and faithfulness toward the house of Israel. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break into song. Sing praise. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God. Anyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might have life through him. In this is love, not that we have loved God, but that he has loved us. He sent his Son as expiation for our sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this, so that my joy may be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment, love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you, and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you. This I command of you, love one another." The Gospel of the Lord. I must admit that the gospel that we have just heard on this sixth Sunday of Easter is one of my favorite gospel passages. It was the gospel passage the very first day I celebrated Mass as a priest nearly 18 years ago. Now, one of the realities is most of the time when you celebrate Mass as a newly ordained priest, you are not the one who gives the homily. Usually a mentor or a friend or the pastor of the parish comes and preaches. Now, one of my priest friends told me that's because you really can't say nice things about yourself, so you have to get someone else to do it. And I've always tried to remember back to some of the things that Father Fate, who was the homilist at my first Mass, said. And while there were some nice things about me, he really did do his job. His job wasn't just to heap praise on one individual or on one segment of the population, but to challenge all of us to continue to do exactly what Jesus is telling us in the gospel today, to love one another. Not just in a casual way, not just in a when it's appropriate for me or when I feel I have time or if you love me more, I'll love you a little, but to truly love one another, to truly open ourselves up and give ourselves to one another, to give ourselves to each other is the great call, the great commandment that Jesus invites us all to live. I must admit also, my favorite line in this gospel passage is the line in the middle when Jesus says, "No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends." And then he immediately tells them, "I have called you friends." Think about that. Think about what a friend is. Think about the relationship of friends. When we are friends with others, we don't assume a certain superiority. We don't invite a certain hierarchical structure. We don't set out to say, well, I'm better than you and he's better than me. That's not part of a friendship. A friendship is when a group of people, whether it is two or three or however many, come together and offer themselves to each other. They offer themselves to each other in their joys and their sorrows, in their gifts and blessings, in their shortcomings. And they do it for and with each other out of love, out of affection. What an incredible gift Jesus gave the disciples in this passage, and what an incredible gift he gives us. For it is not just for those 11 men, it's not just for the others who were part of their company, it is for us today. We have been called friends by Jesus. We have been given the example of his love and his affection. He is the one who has laid down his life for us, and now he asks us to do the same, not just for him, but for one another. And the way in which we lay down our lives could be more appropriately translated to offer our lives up, to offer our lives up in service and in ministry, to have a greater sense of compassion and care and concern, to truly invest ourselves in each other's lives. That is the great commandment, to love one another, to share with one another, to forgive one another, to be there for one another. And that is how we all one day will come to live forever in that beautiful kingdom of light and peace and happiness. As we continue in this season of resurrection, as we continue to celebrate the joy of Easter, let us be very mindful of the blessings and the gifts that God offers us each and every day. Let us not squander those gifts. Let us not store up those gifts for ourselves, but let us share those gifts generously and lovingly each and every day. And now, my dear brothers and sisters, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And now, placing our trust in God, let us turn to our Father and offer our many prayers and petitions.
For the mission of the Church, that we may all express the self-sacrificing love of Jesus in our actions with one another, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the elected officials of our country, that they may act with care and concern toward the people they serve, especially those with the greatest need, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who do not enjoy the comfort and security of a decent place to live, that they may be looked upon with love and generosity by others, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families, that spouses, parents and children, brothers and sisters, and other relatives may treat each other with the love Jesus molded with his disciples, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here today, that we may pass on the love that God has for us to others in our community, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And in a very special way, let us continue to pray for all who are sick, especially for Bishop Murray, that God may grant them the gift of healing and healthy happiness. We pray to the Lord. Amen. Lord, hear our prayer. God, our loving and merciful Father, we have humbly brought ourselves before you this day to praise you and glorify you for the many blessings and gifts you offer us each day. We ask you to hear the prayers we have voiced and the many more that each of us holds in our hearts. Hear and answer them according to your will, for we make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name,
for our good and the good of all his holy church. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain, who now lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and when as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. And we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis our Pope and George our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints. We shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. And now let us offer each other a sign of that peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Once again, we are asking for the prayers of all of the parishioners throughout the six counties of the Diocese of Youngstown for Bishop George Murray, as he continues to battle acute leukemia and undergoes intensive chemotherapy in the coming weeks. Let us continue to keep Bishop Murray and all who are suffering from any illness in our prayers throughout these days. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing. Amen. May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance. Amen. Amen. And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a manner right on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
The Catholic Diocese of Youngstown was established on May 15, 1943. 2018 marks the 75th anniversary of the diocese.
There are six counties which make up the Diocese of Youngstown: Ashtabula, Columbiana, Mahoning, Portage, Stark, and Trumbull. There are five other dioceses in the state of Ohio, Cincinnati being the oldest, Cleveland, Youngstown's mother diocese, Columbus, Steubenville, and Toledo. Youngstown is the smallest in terms of area and the second smallest in terms of population, yet it has a third highest percentage of people identifying themselves as Catholics.
Congratulations, Catholic Diocese, for celebrating 75 years with pride in the past and faith in the future.